Welcome to Uncommon Sense, where we do our best to make it common again. I'm your host, Adrian Alquist, and today I'm joined by Andrew Youngblood, who is the headmaster of Chesterton Cor Jesu, which is our online school. He's also the director of curriculum for our Society of D.K. Chesterton, but we're going to mostly talk about Cor Jesu today. But anyway, how are you, Andrew?
I'm doing great. It's good to see you, Adrian.
Yeah, good to see you too. So first of all, if you're interested in learning about Chesterton Cor Jesu online school, visit ChestertonSchoolsNetwork.org/CorJesu, which is C-O-R-J-E-S-U, Cor-Jesu. And I'll put the link in the description in YouTube. And there you can register for an online virtual open house, which is on January 26th at 7 p.m. Central. So that's a good place to learn a lot more about the Cor Jesu and if it's a good fit for your kid, your children. But yeah, let's get into it. So let's first talk about the Chesterton Schools Network. In case people are unfamiliar or just don't know the details. So what is it and how did it start, Andrew?
Well, I have a feeling that you might know a lot more of the inside and outside of that one, Adrian, because you had boots on the ground when it started. So.
Yeah, that's true. I guess it's kind of a loaded question.
were you part of the first class?
No. So I was back before the Chesterton School Network existed. There was just Chesterton Academy of the Twin Cities. Uh-huh. And so my dad founded that with another person about 3 years before I was in high school. So I was in sixth grade when it started.
Okay.
So they had time to iron out the kinks before I got there.
so between you being young and what I've heard about it, let's see if we can get this correct, right?
Yeah.
So,
okay.
It was about 2000. It was 12 years ago and your dad was having breakfast. I've actually been to the place where he had breakfast, Perkins, right? Perkins, And the gentleman's name is Tom Berksom.
Tom Bankston is the other co-founder of Chesterton Academy.
Yeah. Sorry about that, Tom. And they decided over breakfast to open up a high school. So that was when you were, as you said, in sixth grade.
Yep.
They started. I've heard that it was 10 kids around a table.
Yep.
You would know that. I'm assuming some of your brothers and sisters might have been there.
Well, it was my brother Julian who started teaching there. Actually, he was one of the first teachers. And I knew people who were going there. And also Tom Bankston, his son was in my class all through grade school, so that was fun too. What else?
That actually I think has a lot to do with it because Julian attended Christendom College, correct?
Right.
Where I went to college as well, and where I was teaching in the early 2000s. So they started the Chesterton Academy. Julian was teaching there. They developed a curriculum, and I always attribute it to the fact that your dad went around speaking that, you know, just the word about Chesterton Academy started to get out. And within not too long of a time after it started, people started requesting to replicate it. So at a certain point, and I'm not the person to ask about the details on this one, but at a certain point, they started packaging up the curriculum from the Twin Cities, the first school, and they started offering it to other schools. Fast forward several years, I came in. So I think they started doing that in maybe about 2012 or something.
Yeah,
and then in about 2016, I came on board because a local archdiocesan high school wanted to adopt the Chesterton curriculum. So up until that point, the 10 schools that had adopted the curriculum had all started at their own school. Mm-hmm. And we were a program within an existing school. So that was really sort of stretching the model a little bit and required some creativity.
Okay.
Anyway, the executive director at that point was Emily Drotstein. And one day after my involvement with the Regina Chesterton Academy, where I'm the director at Cardinal O'Hare High School in the Philadelphia suburbs, I was talking with Emily and she just said, you know, we've packaged this curriculum and, you know, she herself is amazing with marketing and
absolutely,
just had an amazing professionalism that she brought to the organization, but her background wasn't in curriculum. And she just asked me to explain to her like how the curriculum fit together. And because I think of Julian and I's shared experience at Christendom, it all seemed very familiar to me. And I actually remember the first time I had eyes on the curriculum, I got it open and I immediately started filling in stuff because I'm like, oh yeah, they did this, but they're missing this. And
cool.
So Yeah, I really felt a familiarity with the curriculum. And because of that conversation, and because of me helping her understand the vision of how the curriculum all fits together, they asked me to come on board as director of curriculum and instruction. We've revised the entire curriculum. We put it online. So many more schools. I said I was the 12th school to join. Last year, we had 18 schools. So it was growing very steadily. Mm-hmm. This year, we have 30.
33, yeah.
And we have over 10 starting in the fall.
Yeah.
And then we have, I think, more than 20 in the pipeline for after that.
I know.
And so it's just, I mean, yeah, it's crazy. The growth is crazy. And I know you know that. You've been to the conference. We had our first Chesterton Schools Network conference 3 years ago. Actually, help me with the name. Is it Black Rock? When the society conference was it Black Rock?
Oh, yeah. Oh man, I forgot the name.
Yeah, there's someplace.
It was a very pretty shrine that we were at for the Chesterton Schools.
No, it was a university. I'm sorry. It was here in Pennsylvania at a university.
Okay.
Remember, it's about 4 years ago, and that was the first Chesterton Schools Network conference, and it was Emily and me and Kathy Posh and Colleen Richards and one other person. It was the five of us, and we're kind of like, so what are we going to do? You're right. And then 2 years later, we had the actual first official conference. We thought we'd have 10 people. We ended up having 25.
Oh, wow.
And then last year it was, or 2 years ago, it was 50. And then last year it was almost 100. So the conference itself, which is attached to the society conference, it's right before the society conference always, mm-hmm. that's growing. The network is growing. And, yeah. You know, you've been through the curriculum. So I think you have a way of really relating to this is just from an educator standpoint, I see that the curriculum works.
Yeah. You know, this might be a good time to get into it. I know we plan to talk about this later after Cor Jesu, but maybe for the people who aren't familiar with the curriculum and don't have this on their radar, what's so special about our curriculum? And I can help out, but
jump in whenever you want. So yeah. I think from a developmental standpoint, like from a philosophical standpoint, and you know, Dr. Carroll from Christendom College had this also, is just understanding the centrality of the incarnation, right? History is not circular. Mark Twain might be right that it rhymes, but it doesn't go in circles. It's really linear. And we know that because we can point to a moment in history where we can say that point is the central point in history, and that's the incarnation. So our curriculum builds towards the incarnation and then the effects of the incarnation in culture and society, in learning and in understanding the truth. You know, it diffuses itself into society and permeates and impacts all aspects of society.
It's kind of like the significance of the shape of the cross that Chesterton talks about. We're not circular. We're not, you know, going in a loop. It's a cross because it has a center point and it spreads out infinitely.
Spreads out from there. Yep.
Yeah, it makes sense. Wow. Sorry, I interrupted.
No, not at all. Jump in whenever. So I think that the centrality of the incarnation is a key understanding that we have, but that doesn't make us unique, right? I mean, I think most Christian and Catholic organizations would have that as a central point. So in addition to that, we layer on this classical approach that we have, the Socratic method, which as a teacher is so exciting. And I think, and I don't want to put words in your mouth, but as a student, when it's done well, it's really the most enticing and most exciting type of learning environment possible.
Yeah, I agree with that. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I've taught Old Testament, you know, 15 times or something like that. So, you know, you're reading a chapter in Exodus and you can remember or you've read it, but every time it's different because the kids are seeing, the students are seeing different things in the passage.
I know.
And so great to be able, it's like, it's an honor to be allowed to be part of that.
Yeah, absolutely. The Socratic method allows us to not feel like we're being spoon-fed the information, mm-hmm. but we're discovering it ourselves, even though the teacher is you know, doing an amazing work and amazing job. We have these click moments and we're like, oh my gosh. And go ahead.
So I don't want to be like the Wizard of Oz and pull back the curtain for you, but so this is exactly, I think, the point where you get to appreciate what the Chesterton Schools Network does, because we've designed a curriculum where those moments, those click moments that you're talking about, mm-hmm. they're written into the curriculum.
Right? I know.
Not only are you supposed to have those click moments, we know what click moments you're going to have, and we know when you should be having them. And if you don't have them, we can feed you a little so that you get them. And we kind of tell the freshman teacher in theology, hey, you want to make sure that you mention this and be clear about it, because this is going to lead to a click moment in history in sophomore year, right? So we write that into the curriculum. We call it points of integration. And we sort of, the theology teacher isn't going to be there for that sophomore year history class, right? When the click happens, but they need to play their role in it. So the curriculum is just, it's designed so beautifully so that all of the 10 courses freshman year are woven together, and they complement each other. And it's not just that the humanities complement each other and the arts complement each other. It's the arts complementing the humanities, the sciences complementing the humanities. They all work together, and it's just really beautiful. But then also it's like a building, because it layers on top of it, one year on top of the next.
Yeah.
So I think that's what you said about the clicks. I think that's a really great way of understanding what we do. That's so special at the Chesterton Academies, because even though the insights are unique and the conversation is unique every time, where we're going and the conversation is the same, and it should be happening in 30 schools pretty much at the same time, and the same clicks should be happening. And then it's really a question of training the teachers to really celebrate the click, right? It's just like, just because we did a lot of work to lay the foundation for that click to happen and for you to see reality in a way that's either Chestertonian or Christian, or the two are very synonymous in many ways. So it's just like, for you to have that, really to engineer it in a way, but then to let it happen organically and then to celebrate it.
Yep.
Because it was it is incarnate in you, right?
Yeah.
We talked about it's all about the incarnation. Like, you just birthed this idea. And traditionally speaking, in classical schools, you call the teacher a midwife, right? That's
the name. Yeah. So I wanted to say, the integration for me was a huge component for my learning. I mean, I got the benefit of going through Chesterton, and now I have the benefit of teaching a few classes there. And there's just so many opportunities to integrate different things that they learn in the curriculum. I'm teaching statistics, and you wouldn't expect one of the math classes to integrate really well, but it just does. We were studying certain probability distributions and certain things that are called a memory list property, and I got to incorporate the idea of the gambler's fallacy, which they learn in philosophy or rhetoric in freshman year. And I'm saying, do you remember the gambler's fallacy? This is why it's wrong. This is why it's a fallacy in statistics terms. And it's just So that's an example I can bring up.
So our challenge on the curriculum committee is not finding the points of integration, but writing a list that's not even semi-exhaustive, right? I mean, it's just there's so many points of integration. I've taught chemistry, I've taught physics, and it just, I'm usually a humanities teacher, my background is theology, philosophy, and Latin and history. But I've subbed for chemistry for prolonged periods of time, and physics, for math. And like, it's just like you said, like, you see these points of integration all over the place, which of course you do, because truth is one, right? Reality has the same author. So we see it over and over again. But I think what makes us unique, so I think that's what makes us great. And I think what makes us unique is that we're able to do this with the attitude and companionship of G.K. Chesterton, right?
Yeah.
That ability to laugh at ourselves, that ability to laugh with others, to be joyful, those really sharp paradoxical insights where it's like, how did I not see that before? And at the same time, you're blown away by how insightful it is. It's just G.K. Chesterton does everything well, and he's just brings everything together for us.
Yeah, so absolutely. That's a well-rounded personality, well-rounded mindset, and bring it into the class, and his joy along with his joy. It's great. Yeah.
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 So that's the Chesterton Schools Network.
Okay, and, cool. In a very bite-sized piece. Yeah. All right. Well, let's get back on track. There'll definitely be times to talk more about the Chesterton Schools Network and what's the amazing thing that's going on. But let's get back on track. So how has things been with the pandemic? Has it had a negative effect? Yeah.
So we're all in this for the first time, right? And when the pandemic hit, we had the benefit of being a network. We had, there were a couple of benefits to that. First of all, and this was really interesting, is we have a school in Italy. And we were starting to have, because of the you know, the talk about the pandemic. The first thing was we had to cancel the March Rome pilgrimages in 20.
Yeah, that was the first time. That was the first thing that happened.
Yeah. So that happened. And then we started having these, because everyone was talking like, what's going on? We started having these weekly calls with our headmasters from all the network schools. And Marco
Sammarini.
Sammarini, thank you. Yeah. He joined us for one of them. And they were about 2 weeks ahead of us in terms of lockdown and everything.
Yeah, that makes
and sense. I remember very clearly him describing the lockdown situation and, you know, needing papers to go to work and nobody can go anywhere except for the store. Mm-hmm. And I was just like, that would never happen in the United States.
Same. You know? I thought that for sure.
So, but he did prepare us for it. So people started taking books home. They started thinking about all of these things. So when the orders started hitting in the different states about, you know, the stay at home orders, we were actually prepared. It was like a 24-hour heads up that we had that a lot of people didn't have. So all my students had their books at home when we went virtual. And I know it sounds like a little thing, but it really made a big difference. And everyone was sort of ready for it to happen. A lot of people didn't know what Zoom was, which, I mean, you can't even fathom that I did a Zoom training for people in March, right?
For sure, like, yeah. I remember I was teaching a calc class at that time. I was only a few students as calc two. And Mr. Baskar, our headmaster, calls me up and says, hey, you want to move the class online? And I'm like, okay. And then we moved the class onto Zoom. I connected my iPad to Zoom and I was able to, you know, show them my notes as I wrote. Like, it was like a whiteboard, and it was actually faster than a whiteboard. So it was fine. But yeah.
Right. So we all adapted, and we had the network to support each other, and we were all talking every week, which was really fantastic. And then despite everything that's going on, the growth in the schools, like I mentioned, we went from 18 to 30 schools in 2020. Mm-hmm. So the growth was still happening. The demand was still there. The demand was even more, was increased. The intensity of the demand was increased because of the pandemic. The desire for this type of education was increased. So yeah, we all did what we needed to do to adapt to get through the 2019-2020 academic year. Mm-hmm. And then 2020 started, we had more schools. And we noticed over the summer, we had been talking a long time about an online offering. And then, yeah, as always, a couple of things happened where it all fell into place. First of all, there was the pandemic, and mm-hmm. we realized that a lot of people were going to be going online. But also, we had the opportunity to partner with one of our network schools in Canada, in the Diocese of Elk Island. There's a school. This is Alberta, Canada. There's a school there that is an online charter school, I believe,
okay,
that's done through the Archdiocese of Alberta, Canada, of Elk Island. And they wanted to adopt the Chesterton program like I had done at my school. So they were an existing online academy, but they wanted to offer the Chesterton curriculum to students. And that's St. Isidore's.
Okay, yeah.
And so they were starting an online presence. And we wanted to start one in the United States as well. Because the academic requirements in the United States and Canada are different, we decided to start up, instead of everyone doing St. Isidore's, we decided to start up an American version. So the math and science sequence in Europe, yeah, and Canada is different from in the United States. So we had to respect that. So we started an American online academy, which is called Chesterton Cor Jesu. And we launched it this year with a full section of students. St. Isidore started. Between the two, we have over 100 online students.
Wow.
So it's just it was an amazing launch, and it happened very quickly.
Yeah.
But what we wanted to do, and again, I mentioned earlier Emily DeRotstein, and this was really her vision, is that, you know, there's a lot of homeschool options available online. There are a lot of online options for.
Yeah, I was going to ask what makes Cor Jesu different from those
other. Yeah, so that's the thing. So she had this vision of what really helps us create these environments where the students encounter Christ, and that's our vision. That's our mission, right? To create these environments where students encounter Christ. It's mm-hmm. not about taking one class or another class, or that we really emphasize the fine arts, or we integrate the fine arts or the sciences, but that we have this academy experience.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it is a full environment. So what we wanted to do was recreate that as much as possible, online for students. So the Chesterton Cor Jesu is the Chesterton Academy experience virtual online for homeschoolers.
So all the things we were talking about with the curriculum, that's those benefits should be with the Cor Jesu online experience as well.
Yeah, so definitely the curriculum. That's actually, besides choral music, pretty much everything in the curriculum we're able to recreate. I mean, drama is challenging. The choral aspect of the music is a little bit challenging, although we do it. But our fine arts is recreated. Cool. And then obviously all the math, sciences, and humanities, that's not an issue. So the curriculum is there, but we wanted to layer more instead of just, we didn't want just an academic experience, because Chesterton is all about the intellectual, but also the spiritual and the leadership formation, the character formation. So we wanted those spiritual and character formation aspects part of it. So at the Chesterton Academy, you know this, we have the house system. So we recreated the house system online. For the students, they have a seminar twice a week where they do have an opportunity to engage each other, to do debate, to do spiritual discussions, to do more than just academics, right? So it can be an academic support. They can do PSAT prep there, or classical learning test CLT prep there, or go over note-taking, things like that. But at the same time, they have an opportunity to talk about discernment. Father Johnson, our chaplain, can come in and talk to the students. We've been able to host retreats for the students. You know, hopefully they'll all be able to go on the pilgrimage that we offer, the Rome pilgrimage in junior year. So we really want to give as much as possible that that environment, not just an intellectual experience, but a full person experience where they're fully engaged.
And to clarify, we want this to be for students, for kids that don't have access to a physical Chesterton. So if they're not, you know, in distance of another Chesterton in the schools network, that's Cor Jesu is right for you. Right. Is that's correct, right?
Yeah. So that is correct. So I think what you're saying is that we really prioritize that the academy experience, and we want to encourage those communities. We don't want to splinter them. So we do encourage our families to participate in a Chesterton Academy experience. But there are people who do not live close to a Chesterton Academy. And for those people, we offer this academy experience.
Yeah. And we're not Subway. We don't have one in every city.
We do not have one in every city by any means, but
yeah. So
watch out. If we keep growing the way we're growing.
Yeah. Well, yeah, that's true.
We'll have pretty good penetration, I think, throughout the United States. Also, it's not just a national thing, right? I mentioned that we have schools in Canada and we have the online school in Canada, but you know how excited I am that we are growing internationally as well. I mentioned the school in Italy. We have schools throughout South America and Europe that are discussing opening up.
Yeah,
but
that's amazing.
One that is definitely opening up, one that is a go, is Erbil, Iraq.
Yep.
So
I know, it's crazy.
Archbishop, Iraq. I know, it's crazy, right? The the Archbishop has invited us, and so a team of us will be going early in March to Erbil, Iraq, to help them. They have an existing school and they want to adopt the Chesterton program in their high school. So we're going to help them, you know, train the teachers for the curriculum, make any adaptations that we need to do, because as you know, the curriculum has elements of a very Anglo-Saxon basis in certain areas like Beowulf and King Arthur, to replace those with books that accomplish the same thing in the Arab world as King Arthur does in the Christian world. I'm sorry, not the Christian world, but in the English speaking world, to find their Christian equivalent in the Arab speaking world of what King Arthur does, right?
Which I remember the first time I got to talk to you at this last conference, we were having a discussion about how is the curriculum going to translate to a culture in Iraq, and you were talking about this, like we want to preserve the narratives that we have in, you know, that we tell, but we can tell it through their lens, through a different culture.
Yeah. So for example, in the curriculum sophomore year, we have Beowulf and then King Arthur.
Yeah.
Beowulf, besides being an old Anglo-Saxon poem, also shows pagan culture that is being Christianized. Hmm. And then it's followed by King Arthur, which is a Christian culture that still has pagan elements, right? Merlin's walking around talking to the archbishops, but he's a druid, right? So that there's still pagan elements there. but those are specific to the Anglo-speaking Christian world. So we want to find out what is it in the Arab world. And there's so many rich resources there. I mean, basically, we're going back to the land of Abraham to a certain extent, wow. right? Yeah. So there are so many, and Alexander the Great. Mm-hmm. Like, there's so many rich historical things. So for me to broaden my own horizon and to learn the beauty of this culture more and appreciate it more and to bring it into our curriculum, it's just, I mean, for someone who loves curriculum, and I really love curriculum, it's really a dream come true.
I bet. Okay, that's great. So let's say I'm a parent and I'm not in walking or driving distance of another Chesterton Academy. How do I find out more about Cor Jesu, and how do I, you know, let's say I'm interested in having my kid apply. How do we get there? Yeah.
Right. So, I mean, obviously the first thing you do, the web search, you find the Chesterton Cor Jesu page. There are videos there. There's some information mm-hmm. there. That'll kind of give you a sense of what our curriculum is and what the experience is meant to be like. After that, so then you've done that, you're kind of interested, you want to take it to the next step. What do you do? So you want to register. There's a register for the virtual open house, which is January 26th. And we've had open houses previously, and those video recordings, I think, are on the website as well. So, you know, do what you need to do to get to the point where you're excited enough to come to the open house. Come to the open house. You get to meet some of our teachers, talk to them. And then next step, if you know, as you progress along this discernment process, your child, once you register for the for Chesterton Cor Jesu, your child will be allowed to do a shadow day with a student, right? So they'll be able to sit in on a class and experience the curriculum. And you know, once you experience the curriculum, most people get sold pretty quickly. Like, it's great. You know, you usually have to explain a few things going into it, but then once the kids get into the class and they see the Socratic dialogue, it's so different from a lot of what kids experience. Oh, and most kids are just like, yes, please, right?
It's unbelievable.
So then they sign up, and then there'll be an application process. And we have a wonderful staff that can answer all of your questions along the way. Actually, Adrian, you're part of our staff for Chesterton Cor Jesu, so you might be answering some of the questions.
Yep.
So it's another thing about the joy of Chesterton, right? Like there's a lot of joy working in the Chesterton group. It's so wonderful being able to work with a lot of these people that are so wonderful.
Yeah, one of the teachers at Cor Jesu, I went to school with at Chesterton, and she was in my class, and she's great. I'm glad you got her for a teacher.
She's awesome. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And it's also really nice because, you know, you as a teacher, you're in a one locale basically, right? But we have such phenomenal teachers throughout the network. And think about it, we have 30 schools. So, you know, what do we have? Like 300 teachers?
Yeah.
Maybe more. Mm-hmm. And so many of them have so much to offer that we're just so excited to give a national and international platform to. Yep. Like, for example, we were just talking about music, right? So one of our headmasters is a PhD in music, and he was doing the music class. And I was so happy to be able to give him a wider, you know, a national audience, because he really needs that. But then, unfortunately, because of the demands of being a headmaster, he had to step back. So we have another teacher who's his credentials are just so amazing that mm-hmm. now he's teaching the class. So We kind of have an embarrassment of riches with our faculties.
I know, it's true. It's true.
And so to be able to give them a wider audience. And one thing, you know, I'll be completely transparent. This is our first year. So we had some glitches with technology and things like that. But one thing the parents have been just unanimous about is how wonderful the faculty are and how much they love the curriculum.
That's great. Yeah, I'm glad the technology didn't get in the way of the good experience with the teachers. And
no, and we all have that ironed out for next year. So
yeah, that's
no more technology issues.
Nice. Well, that's amazing. That's great. That sounds amazing. I wish I could be in on some of those online classes, even though I've already gone through Chesterton and teach there now. Is there anything else you wanted to address before we wrap up?
Well, we could really use everyone's help. So even if the Chesterton Cor Jesu doesn't sound right for you, just because of where you're at in life or your kids are situated, we ask that you please go to the Facebook page, like it, send it out. I'm going to really show my social media ignorance by what I'm about to say, but I don't know. What do? You like it and then you share it or
follow it. You follow it.
See, I'm in really dangerous.
I didn't know that.
I'm really dangerous territory when I start talking about social media, but, yeah, but help us get the word out, spread the word. At the end of the day, this is an apostolate that your dad started, that goes along with his apostolate for G.K. Chesterton. And it's about bringing kids closer to Christ. Mm-hmm. And it works. I mean, I see it year after year. The curriculum works. I use my seniors to talk to the freshmen about, you know, get ready to encounter Christ while you're here in high school. You know, you're ready for sports, you're ready for friends, you're ready for learning. But the one thing that you might not have on your horizon is that you might meet Christ in these next 4 years and be ready for it. And then they give a witness to the day and the moment that they, you know, encountered the living Christ and how it impacted their lives. And it just, you know,
breathtaking.
It's overwhelming because wow, I was there for that, you know, and it's life-changing. And it's so much more than what high school is. It's high school that just helps you prepare for heaven, you know?
Yeah. Well, thank you so much, Andrew. Thank you for giving that pitch and that explanation. That was great talking about the curriculum. That was fun.
It's always fun. I love it. So
yeah. So everyone, if remember ChestertonSchoolsNetwork.org/core-Jesu, G-E-S-U. But I'll put the link in the description and I'll put the Facebook page too, so you can like and follow it. And that's awesome. Yeah, thank you so much for being with us, Andrew. Thank you all for listening. And until next time, help us to make uncommon sense more common.